Hey drummers, it's Rob Litton here from drumstheword.com. Welcome to this mini song lesson where today I want to show you an absolute classic, Bittersweet Symphony by the Verve, drummed by Peter Salisbury. And I've got the free PDF you can download from my website for free. You'll find the link beneath this video. So have this printed out in front of you as we go through this together. It's going to make things a lot easier for you to understand. I've got the main drum beat, and then we've also got this really cool little subtle drum fill that occurs occasionally throughout the song. So the first thing is the main drum beat. We're playing eighth notes on the hi-hat. One and two and three and four and one. We get this and four in the second half of the bar. We also get this little push on the bass drum on the of two into beat three. One and two and a three. One and two and a three and four. And then it ends with and one at the end. One and two and a three and four and one and two and a three and four and one. The second bar is identical, except we get and four and at the end. Instead of and four and, it's and four and. One and two and a three and four and one and two and a three and four and. Both bars together a bit faster. One and two and a three and four and one and two, a three and four and one, two, a three and four and one, two, a three and four and. Lots of fun to play. Here it is up to speed. So then at 2 minutes 17, we get a little subtle drum filly idea, which is very cool. It's the same two bar pattern, but then the first bar we get a slight difference. Instead of playing and four and one in the first bar, we get and still on the and of three with the snare drum. But then we get this 4E, an accent on beat four, normal volume snare drum, followed by a ghost note with the left hand. So our left hand is playing two notes there, 4E, 4E. 4E, the E there is written in brackets, it's a ghost note, it's played quietly. 4E, we then come up to the hi-hat to play and a 1. So we get this sort of linear idea, not really linear, but this flow of notes between the snare drum and the hi-hat. Underneath it, we get and 1 with the bass drum. So 4E and a 1 with the bass drum, 4E and a 1. If I play that bar around a few times, one, two, a three, and four, E, and a one, two, a three, and four, E, and a one. Sometimes I might accidentally play the E a little bit too quiet. Don't worry about making it super silent. It's just supposed to be a little bit quieter than the snare drum on beat four. The second bar is the same as above. So both bars at a medium tempo, one, two, a three, and four, E, and a one, two, a three, and four, and then up to speed. So I hope you enjoyed that lesson. Feel free to email me, rob@drumstheword.com, if you've got any questions. Also, don't forget to download the free PDF that came with this lesson. There's the link beneath the video. And then while you're over at my website, you might want to consider signing up to become an online member. And what I currently offer for £97 is a full year's online access to every single full video song lesson I've ever recorded and transcribed. And that's over 600 famous and popular songs where I teach you the song from start to finish. You get the fully transcribed PDF drum chart for each of those lessons. And like I said, I've got over 600 famous and popular songs, including, I believe, off the top of my memory, at least one other Verve song. If I haven't, that's sacrilege. I must get some more Verve up there, and I'm sure I will in the future. As a thank you for signing up, I give you access to hundreds more little videos teaching you many, many famous drum beats, fills, and even drum solos. I give you 3 ebooks I've written over the years containing hundreds more famous beats, fills, and solos. And then over the year of your subscription, you also gain instant online access to all the new material that I upload for my members. And I record new lessons every week unless I'm ill or on holiday. So you've got lots of cool stuff to look forward to over the year of your subscription. But if you've got any questions about any of that, then feel free to email me, robertdrumstheword.com. And until our next drum lesson together, toodle pip and happy drumming to you.